This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. In linguistics, intonation is variation of spoken pitch that is not used to distinguish words. Instead, it is used for a range of functions such as indicating the attitudes and emotions of the speaker, signaling the difference between statements and questions, and between different types of questions, focusing attention on important elements of the spoken message and also helping to regulate conversational interaction. It contrasts with tone, in which pitch variation in some languages distinguishes words, either lexically or grammatically. The term tone is used by some British writers in their descriptions of intonation, but to refer to the pitch movement found on the nucleus or tonic syllable in an intonation unit. See intonation in English, British Analyses of English Intonation, below. Although intonation is primarily a matter of pitch variation, it is important to be aware that functions attributed to intonation, such as the expression of attitudes and emotions, or highlighting aspects of grammatical structure, almost always involve concomitant variation in other prosodic features. David Crystal, for example, says that intonation is not a single system of contours and levels, but the product of the interaction of features from different prosodic systems, tone, pitch range, loudness, rhythmicality and tempo in particular. Contents 1. Transcription 2. Functions 3. In English 31. American Approaches to English Intonation 32. The Toby System 33. British Analyses of English Intonation 4. In French 41. Summary 42. Detail 421. Continuation Pattern 422. Finality Pattern 423. Yes, No Pattern 424. Information Question Pattern 5. In Mandarin Chinese 6. In Punjabi 7. Comparative Studies of Intonation 8. Disorders of Intonation 9. See also 10. References 11. Bibliography 12. External links. Transcription. Most transcription conventions have been devised for describing one particular accent or language, and the specific conventions therefore need to be explained in the context of what is being described. However, for general purposes, the International Phonetic Alphabet offers the two intonation marks shown in the box at the head of this article. Global rising and falling intonation are marked with a diagonal arrow rising left to right and falling left to right, respectively. These may be written as part of a syllable, or separated with a space when they have a broader scope. He found it on the street. Here the rising pitch on street indicates that the question hinges on that word, on where he found it, not whether he found it. Yes, he found it on the street. How did you ever escape here? As is common with WH questions, there is a rising intonation on the question word, and a falling intonation at the end of the question. In many descriptions of English, the following intonation patterns are distinguished. Rising intonation means the pitch of the voice rises over time. Falling intonation means that the pitch falls with time. Dipping or fall rise intonation falls and then rises. Peaking or rise fall intonation rises and then falls. It is also common to trace the pitch of a phrase with a line above the phrase, adjacent to the phrase, or even through overstriking the phrase. Such usage is not supported by Unicode as of 2015, but the symbols have been submitted. The following example requires an SIL font such as Gentium Plus. MMMT da ja da jays. Functions. All vocal languages use pitch pragmatically in intonation, for instance for emphasis, to convey surprise or irony, or to pose a question. Tonal languages such as Chinese and Hausa use intonation in addition to using pitch for distinguishing words. Many writers have attempted to produce a list of distinct functions of intonation. Perhaps the longest was that of Wrlee, who proposed 10, and both put forward 6 functions. Wells's list is given below. The examples are not his. Attitudinal function for expressing emotion and attitudes. Example, a fall from a high pitch on the more syllable of good morning suggests more excitement than a fall from a low pitch. Grammatical function to identify grammatical structure. Example, it is claimed that in English a falling pitch movement is associated with statements, but a rising pitch turns a statement into a yes-no question, as in he's going up right arrow home. This use of intonation is more typical of American English than of British, focusing to show what information in the utterance is new and what is already known. Example, in English I saw a down right arrow man in the garden. Answers, whom did you see, or what happened, while I down right arrow saw a man in the garden. Answers, did you hear a man in the garden. Discourse function to show how clauses and sentences go together in spoken discourse example. Subordinate clauses often have lower pitch, faster tempo and narrower pitch range than their main clause, as in the case of the material in parentheses in The Red Planet as it's known as Forth from the Sun. Psychological function to organize speech into units that are easy to perceive, memorize and perform example. The utterance "you can have it in red, blue, green, yellow or downright arrow black" is more difficult to understand and remember than the same utterance divided into tone units as in "you can have it in upright arrow red, upright arrow blue, upright arrow green, upright arrow yellow, or downright arrow black." Indexical function to act as a marker of personal or social identity example. Group membership can be indicated by the use of intonation patterns adopted specifically by that group, such as street vendors or preachers. The so-called high-rising terminal, where a statement ends with a high-rising pitch movement, is said to be typical of younger speakers of English, and possibly to be more widely found among young female speakers. Is not known whether such a list would apply to other languages without alteration in English. The description of English intonation has developed along different lines in the US and in Britain. American approaches to English intonation. The dominant framework used for American English from the 1940s to the 1990s was based on the idea of pitch phonemes, or tonemes. In the work of Traeger and Smith, there are four contrastive levels of pitch: low 1, middle 2, high 3, and very high 4. Unfortunately, the important work of Kenneth Pike on the same subject had the four pitch levels labeled in the opposite way, with 1 being high and 4 being low in its final form. The Traeger and Smith system was highly complex, each pitch phoneme having four pitch allophones or allotones. There was also a terminal contour to end an intonation clause, as well as four stress phonemes. Some generalizations using this formalism are given below. It should be noted that the American linguist Dwight Bollinger carried on a long campaign to argue that pitch contours were more important in the study of intonation than individual pitch levels. Normal conversation is usually at middle or high pitch. Low pitch occurs at the end of utterances other than yes-no questions, while high pitch occurs at the end of yes-no questions. Very high pitch is for strong emotion or emphasis. Pitch can indicate attitude. For example, great uttered in isolation can indicate weak emotion, with pitch starting medium and dropping to low, enthusiasm with pitch starting very high and ending low, or sarcasm with pitch starting and remaining low. Declarative sentences show a 2-3-1 pitch pattern if the last syllable is prominent. The final decline in pitch is a glide. For example, in "this is fun," "this is" at pitch 2, and "fun" starts at level 3 and glides down to level 1. But if the last prominent syllable is not the last syllable of the utterance, the pitch fall off is a step. For example, in "that can be frustrating," "that can be" has pitch 2, "frus" has level 3, and both syllables of "tratting" have pitch 1. Wh questions work the same way, as in "who 2 will 2 help 3 down right arrow 1 and "who 2 did 3 at 1." But if something is left unsaid, the final pitch level 1 is replaced by pitch 2. Thus in "John's 2 sick 3 down right arrow 2, with the speaker indicating more to come, "John's has pitch 2 while 6 starts at pitch 3 and drops only to pitch 2. Yes no questions with a 2 up right arrow 3 intonation pattern usually have subject verb inversion, as in "have 2 you 2 got 2 a 2 minute 3, 3 here a 2 up right arrow 4 contour would show more emotion, while a 1 up right arrow 2 contour would show uncertainly. Another example is "has 2 the 2 plane 3 left 3 already 3, 3, 3, which, depending on the word to be emphasized, could move the location of the rise, as in "has 2 the 2 plane 2 left 3 already 3, 3, 3 or "has 2 the 2 plane 2 left 2 already 2, 3, 3 and for example, the latter question could also be framed without subject-verb inversion but with the same pitch contour. "The 2 plane 2 has 2 left 2 already 2, 3, 3 tag questions with declarative intent at the end of a declarative statement follow a 3 down right arrow 1 contour rather than a rising contour, since they are not actually intended as yes-no questions, as in "we 2 should 2 visit 3, 1 him 1, shouldn't 3, 1 we 1." But tag questions exhibiting uncertainty, which are interrogatory in nature, have the usual 2 up right arrow 3 contour, as in "we 2 should 2 visit 3, 1 him 1, shouldn't 3, 3 we 3 questions with or can be ambiguous in English writing with regard to whether they are either or questions or yes no questions. But intonation in speech eliminates the ambiguity. For example, "would 2 you 2 like 2 juice 3 or 2 soda 3, 1 emphasize emphasizes juice and soda separately and equally, and ends with a decline in pitch, thus indicating that this is not a yes-no question but rather a choice question equivalent to which would you like, juice or soda. In contrast, would 2 you 2 like 2 juice 3 or 3 soda 3, 3 has yes-no intonation and thus is equivalent to would you like something to drink such as juice or soda. Thus the two basic sentence pitch contours are rising falling and rising. However, other within sentence rises and falls result from the placement of prominence on the stressed syllables of certain words. Note that for declaratives or WH questions with a final decline, the decline is located as a step down to the syllable after the last prominently stressed syllable, or as a down glide on the last syllable itself if it is prominently stressed. But for final rising pitch on yes-no questions, the rise always occurs as an upward step to the last stressed syllable, and the high 3 pitch is retained through the rest of the sentence. The Toby system, a more recent approach to the analysis of intonation, grew out of the research of Janet Peer Humbert and developed into the system most widely known by the name of Toby, short for tones and break indices. The approach is sometimes referred to as autosegmental. The most important points of this system are the following: only 2 tones, associated with pitch accents, are recognized, these being H high and L low. All other tonal contours are made up of combinations of H, L and some other modifying elements in addition to the 2 tones mentioned above. The phonological system includes break indices used to mark the boundaries between prosodic elements. Breaks may be of different levels. Tones are linked to stressed syllables. An asterisk is used to indicate a tone that must be aligned with a stressed syllable. In addition, there are phrasal accents which signal the pitch at the end of an intermediate phrase, e.g. H- and L-, and boundary tones at full phrase boundaries, e.g. H% and L%. A full Toby transcription includes not only the above phonological elements, but also the acoustic signal on which the transcription is based. The Toby system is intended to be used in computer-based transcription. A simplified example of a Toby transcription is given below. In this example, 2 phrases, "we looked at the sky" and "saw the clouds" are combined into one larger intonational phrase. There is a rise on "sky" and a fall on "clouds". Possibly others, the nucleus may be preceded by a head containing stressed syllables preceding the nucleus, and a tail consisting of syllables following the nucleus within the tone unit. Unstressed syllables preceding the head if present, or nucleus if there is no head, constitute a pre-head. This approach was further developed by Halliday and by O'Connor and Arnold, though with considerable variation in terminology. This standard British treatment of intonation in its present-day form is explained in detail by Wells and in a simplified version by Roach. Halliday saw the functions of intonation as depending on choices in 3 main variables: tonality, division of speech into intonation units, tonicity, the placement of the tonic syllable or nucleus, and tone, choice of nuclear tone. These terms, sometimes referred to as the 3 T's, have been used more recently. Research by Crystal emphasized the importance of making generalizations about intonation based on authentic, unscripted speech, and the roles played by prosodic features such as tempo, pitch range, loudness, and rhythmicality in communicative functions usually attributed to intonation. The transcription of intonation in such approaches is normally incorporated into the line of text. A typical example would be, "we looked at the upright arrow sky, and saw the downright arrow clouds." In this example, the mark indicates a division between intonation units. An influential development in British studies of intonation has been discourse intonation, an offshoot of discourse analysis first put forward by David Brazil. This approach lays great emphasis on the communicative and informational use of intonation, pointing out its use for distinguishing between presenting new information and referring to old, shared information, as well as signaling the relative status of participants in a conversation, e.g. teacher-pupil, or doctor-patient, and helping to regulate conversational turn-taking. The description of intonation in this approach owes much to Halliday. Intonation is analyzed purely in terms of pitch movements and key, and makes little reference to the other prosodic features usually thought to play a part in conversational interaction. In French summary, French intonation differs substantially from that of English. There are 4 primary patterns. The continuation pattern is a rise in pitch occurring in the last syllable of a rhythm group, typically a phrase. The finality pattern is a sharp fall in pitch occurring in the last syllable of a declarative statement. The yes, no intonation is a sharp rise in pitch occurring in the last syllable of a yes, no Question: The information question intonation is a rapid fall off from high pitch on the first word of a non-yes, no question, often followed by a small rise in pitch on the last syllable of the question. Detail continuation pattern: The most distinctive feature of French intonation is the continuation pattern. While many languages, such as English and Spanish, place stress on a particular syllable of each word, and while many speakers of languages such as English may accompany this stress with a rising intonation, French has neither stress nor distinctive intonation on a given syllable. Instead, on the final syllable of every rhythm group except the last one in a sentence, there is placed a rising pitch. For example, P35. Note that as before, the pitch change arrows down right arrow and up right arrow apply to the syllable immediately following the arrow. Higher up right arrow soir, ilma off up right arrow ert un siga down right arrow ret. The English equivalent would be last eve up right arrow ning, he offered up right arrow me a cigar down right arrow et le lendemain ma up right arrow tin, après avoir changé le pansement du ma up right arrow laid, l'infer up right arrow meyer est ren up right arrow traché down right arrow lui. Adjectives are in the same rhythm group as their noun. Each item in a list forms its own rhythm group. Chez le fruit up right arrow tir on trouvé des up right arrow palm, des au up right arrow ranges, des bas up right arrow nains, des up right arrow phrases et des abri down right arrow caught. Side comments inserted into the middle of a sentence form their own rhythm group. La grande up right arrow guerre, si j'ai une bonne me acute more, a dure quatre down right arrow ans. Finality pattern as can be seen in the example sentences above, a sharp fall in pitch is placed on the last syllable of a declarative statement. The preceding syllables of the final rhythm group are at a relatively high pitch. Yes, no pattern most commonly in informal speech. A yes, no question is indicated by a sharply rising pitch alone, without any change or rearrangement of words. For example, P65 il est up right arrow riche. A form found in both spoken and written French is the est cek, is it that construction, in which the spoken question can end in either a rising or a falling pitch. Est cek il est up right arrow riche or est cek il est down right arrow riche. The most formal form for a yes, no question, which is also found in both spoken and written French, inverts the order of the subject and verb thereto. The spoken question can end in either a rising or a falling pitch. Est il up right arrow riche or est il down right arrow riche. Sometimes yes, no questions begin with a topic phrase, specifying the focus of the utterance. Then, the initial topic phrase follows the intonation pattern of a declarative sentence, and the rest of the question follows the usual yes, no question pattern. P78 et set fa down right arrow to la up right arrow prize. Information question pattern: information questions begin with a question word such as qui, pourquoi, combien, etc., referred to in linguistics as interrogatives. The question word may be followed in French by est cek as in English, where is it that, or est cek, or by inversion of the subject-verb order as in where goes he. The sentence starts at a relatively high pitch which falls away rapidly after the question word, or its first syllable in case of a polysyllabic question word. There may be a small increase in pitch on the final syllable of the question. For example, P88 up right arrow o down right arrow part il. In both cases, the question both begins and ends at higher pitches than does a declarative sentence in informal speech. The question word is sometimes put at the end of the sentence. In this case, the question ends at a high pitch, often with a slight rise on the high final syllable. The question may also start at a slightly higher pitch. P90 il part up right arrow o o r up right arrow il down right arrow part up right arrow o. In Mandarin Chinese, Mandarin Chinese is a tonal language, so pitch contours within a word distinguish the word from other words with the same vowels and consonants. Nevertheless, Mandarin also has intonation patterns that indicate the nature of the sentence as a whole. There are four basic sentence types having distinctive intonation: declarative sentences, unmarked interrogative questions, yes-no questions marked as such with the sentence final particle ma, and a not a questions of the form he go not go, meaning does he go or not. In the Beijing dialect, they are intonationally distinguished for the average speaker as follows, using a pitch scale from 1 lowest to 9 highest. Declarative sentences go from pitch level 3 to 5 and then down to 2 and 1. A not a questions go from 6 to 9 to 2 to 1. Yes no ma questions go from 6 to 9 to 4 to 5. Unmarked questions go from 6 to 9 to 4 to 6. Thus, questions are begun with a higher pitch than are declarative sentences. Pitch rises and then falls in all sentences, and in yes-no questions and unmarked questions pitch rises at the end of the sentence, while for declarative sentences and a not a questions the sentence ends at very low pitch because Mandarin distinguishes words on the basis of within-syllable tones. These tones create fluctuations of pitch around the sentence patterns indicated above. Thus, sentence patterns can be thought of as bands whose pitch varies over the course of the sentence, and changes of syllable pitch cause fluctuations within the band. Furthermore, the details of Mandarin intonation are affected by various factors like the tone of the final syllable, the presence or absence of focus centering of attention on the final word, and the dialect of the speaker in Punjabi. Intonation in Punjabi has always been an area of discussion and experimentation. There are different studies: Gill and Gleason 1969, Malik 1995, Kaura 1982, Bhatia 1993, Joshi 1972. Phonology of Punjabi intonation based on sentences read in isolation. His research design is based on the classification of two different levels of intonation: horizontal level and vertical level. The first experiment, i.e. at the horizontal level, is conducted to investigate three utterance types: declarative, imperative, and interrogative. In his second experiment, the investigation of sentences declarative, imperative, and interrogative are conducted to view intonation but in vertical sense. Vertical here means a comparative analysis of intonations of these three types of sentences by keeping the nuclear intonation constant. This experiment shows some extremely significant results. The vertical level demonstrates four different types of accentuations in Punjabi language: 1 normal statement, 2 simple emphatic, 3 confirmation, 4 information, 5 doubtful, exclamation. Experiment 2 provides a significant difference between the horizontal level and the vertical level. Comparative studies of intonation. Cruttenden points out the extreme difficulty of making meaningful comparisons among the intonation systems of different languages, the difficulty being compounded by the lack of an agreed descriptive framework. Falling intonation is said to be used at the end of questions in some languages, including Hawaiian, Fijian, and Samoan, and in Greenlandic it is also used in Hawaiian Creole English, presumably derived from Hawaiian. Rises are common on statements in urban Belfast. Falls on most questions have been said to be typical of urban lead speech. An ESRC-funded project, E. Grabe, B. Post, and F. Nolan, to study the intonation of 9 urban accents of British English in 5 different speaking styles has resulted in the IV corpus and a purpose-built transcription system. The corpus and notation system can be downloaded from the project's website. Following on this work is a paper explaining that the dialects of British and Irish English vary substantially. A project to bring together descriptions of the intonation of 20 different languages, ideally using a unified descriptive framework, INTSINT, resulted in a book published in 1998 by D. Hurst and A. D. Christo. The languages described are American English, British English, German, Dutch, Swedish, Danish, Spanish, European Portuguese, Brazilian Portuguese, French, Italian, Romanian, Russian, Bulgarian, Greek, Finnish, Hungarian, Western Arabic, Moroccan, Japanese, Thai, Vietnamese, and Beijing Chinese. A number of contributing authors did not use the INTSINT system but preferred to use their own system. Disorders of intonation. Those with congenital amusia show impaired ability to discriminate, identify and imitate the intonation of the final words in sentences. See also prosody. Linguistics affect linguistics. High rising terminal. List of language disorders. Prosodic unit. References. Carrot Crystal 1975, p. Goodwin 1996, p. Intonation Patterns of French, River Seine Publications, Melbourne, 1980. http://uandrulancom/andrulian/prou/if_teacher/if_teacher PDF. Carat A. B. Shack, Katrina. Comparison of Intonation Patterns in Mandarin and English for a Particular Speaker, University of Rochester. Working Papers in the Language Sciences, Spring 2000, No. 1, p. 29. https://rochesterdu/college/cls/assets/pdf/working/shackpdf. Carat Shen, Xiao Nan. Susan. The Prosody of Mandarin Chinese, Volume 118 of University of California Publications in Linguistics, Berkeley, University of California Press, 1990, p. 95. Carat Singh, Chandrashekhar. 2014, Punjabi Intonation, An Experimental Study. München, Germany, Lincom Europa. Carat Cruttenden 1997, p. Carat Hurst. Halliday, Mach 1967 Intonation and Grammar in British English, Mouton Halliday, Mach, and Greaves, W.S., Intonation in the Grammar of English, London, Equinox, 2008 Hearst, D.J. Palmer, He 1922 English Intonation with Systematic Exercises, Hefferpeer Humbert, Janet B. 1980 The Phonology and Phonetics of English Intonation, PhD Thesis, Massachusetts Institute of Technology, published by Indiana Linguistics Club 1987 Pike, K.L. 1945 The Intonation of American English, University of Michigan Press Roach, Peter Chapter 2009 English Phonetics and Phonology, 4th edition, Cambridge University Press Shack, Katrina Comparison of Intonation Patterns in Mandarin and English for a Particular Speaker, University of Rochester Working Papers in the Language Sciences, Spring 2000, No. 1, p. Listen to this article info per Desi Leader. This audio file was created from a revision of the Intonation Linguistics article dated 26 January 2006, and does not reflect subsequent edits to the article audio help more spoken articles VE suprasegmentals timing syllable mora metrical foot vowel reduction tone tone contour pitch accent register downstep upstep. Downdrift tone terracing floating tone tone sandy tone letter stress secondary stress vowel reduction accent length chrome gemination vowel length extra short prosody intonation pitch pitch contour pitch reset. Stress rhythm loudness prosodic unit pausa.